a Kings fan. That may be an understatement. And like many very normal fans, I love my team passionately. I have been known to cry for victories, throw things for defeats, and I may or may not have made my own children cry on more than one occasion with my vocal cheer. But I'm also your fan. Each October, I am filled with such excitement at what is to come for the new season. The same is true for each new school year. I can barely sleep the night before because I'm so excited. I remember 10 months ago, seeing your smiling faces, well, most of you were smiling, on the first day of school. Looking at you now, it's hard to believe you're the same kids that greeted me that day. Like with any great hockey team, it takes some time to get a new class to become comfortable with a new teacher, new classmates, and new routines. But unlike my Kings, you have all worked really hard this year to master every task I've given you and are only getting better as the year goes on. Whether it's making candles, writing career reports, climbing a rock wall, or memorizing a We the People speech, you faced every challenge I gave you and didn't back down. You have grown so much academically, but more importantly, you've grown as people. I've seen you cheer each other on through fears, tears, or even just a bad day. For many of you, Lang Ranch is the only school you've ever known. It truly is your home away from home. Some of these kids in our class you've known for 6 years, which is over half your lives. Friends are there to help you carry on. Your friendships will be tested, but you will always have the ranch. You will always be able to look back and think about your favorite activities from fifth grade and remember your friends who got you through. You helped each other learn about yourselves and how to become better citizens. Words like patriotism, sportsmanship, perseverance, and dependability are now more than just words that are really hard to spell. They describe all of you. You do care about our country and strive to make it a better place. You are good sports and cheer on your own successes while congratulating others on theirs. You never give up, even when the road ahead is rough, like our performance was when we first started practicing. I know I can count on all of you, and more importantly, you can count on yourself and each other. While you are well on your way on your own journeys that will take you beyond the doors of the ranch, I do have some parting words of advice that you may want to take with you as you continue downward. Be kind. Remember that to have good friends, you need to be a good friend. Be responsible. As your posters tell everyone at the ranch, each right you have has responsibilities that go along with it. Keep learning. As you like to remind me, I'm pretty old, and you kids are still teaching me new things every day. Have a sense of humor. Things don't look so bad when you can laugh at them. Finally, be problem solvers. Trust yourselves and your abilities, and you will become leaders in the world like you are at the ranch. I am so proud of each and every one of you. I will miss you all, but I know the next leg of your journey will be as great as you make it. My mom was my best friend and was very important to me. I even named my second daughter after her. One of my mom's favorite sayings rings true to me today. She never said, have a great day, because that takes your power out of it. So I will leave you with words that always make me smile and try a little harder. Make a great day. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present to you the culminating class of 2017. Annalise Conrath, Lilith Harris, Jonathan St. Pierre.